About that time. Ready for Bristol?
Yep.
Let's go.
Smokecover 13, and welcome back to another NASCAR vlog. We are here for Bristol Dirt. Kind of been like a every year trip now since I've been to all the Bristol Dirt races they've been having. We got a good old Mr. Big T right here, Thomas, with us.
What's up?
So I'm excited to be back at Bristol. Tennessee is such an awesome state. Bristol is one of my favorite tracks. So they got the heat races in about hour and a half right now, and then they got the truck race tonight. So looking forward to that. I don't know who's gonna win the truck race. Who do you got winning?
Well, if I had to narrow it down to three people, I'm gonna say Carson Hocevar, William Byron, and I'm gonna say Stewart.
I think Byron is gonna be up there. But Stewart Friesen is another guy, but I would keep an eye out on Jonathan Davenport because he's one of the biggest dirt racers out there. Tyler Carpenter. Tyler Carpenter is another guy to watch out too. So see how they do, and we're just going to go out and walk around and stop at a couple tents and buy some NASCAR merch. So let's head on out.
You ready to rock and roll?
Yep.
Alrighty. Let's rock and roll.
I don't know about this weather. It's cloudy at the track. Hopefully they're not calling any more rain, but it is cold, just like how Atlanta was. It was really cold, but today is cold. But tonight is supposed to get even more colder. But hey, I'm here to watch some good racing. But man, somebody's cooking some delicious ribs. I can smell it. But ready to head onto the track and buy some merch.
It was warm, you know?
Yeah, last year was warm. But it rained like later in the night.
This year is cold as shit.
Yeah.
We just got out the car.
Yeah.
He ain't even made it to the track yet. It's already freezing.
Yeah.
I kind of want to try that shit.
Farm raised gator on the stick. Might be good though.
Bristol's just unique anyway.
Yeah, Bristol is unique. I mean, look, it's pretty much like built on a mountainside, pretty much.
One of the best times we've had going to races is at Bristol.
Yeah.
It's always good racing. It's always, you see friends like Iceberg and Darian. What's his name, Black Lives Matter?
Yeah, that's Darian.
You know, just good people.
Mm-hmm. They got the official souvenirs. They got all the merch haulers. Got some, a lot of nice stuff. There's the Bristol baby sign right there. Look at all these nice looking haulers with all these merch. Alright, it's time to get our race pin and stuff. Got the Chase Elliott hauler right there.
I got Jonathan Davenport.
Yeah, Jonathan Davenport's hauler. Pretty cool. Looks like they got all kinds of other dirt racer shirt merch and stuff. We'll see what kind of stuff they got. The what? 27. Where's it at? Oh, the hats.
That's pretty nice looking hat. Bought a cool hoodie, and I actually bought the Hendrick driver sign. Didn't know if it was metal. We got good old Todd Gibbs, Truex, Hamlin, Christopher Bell. Got the Penske hauler right here. Got all the Stewart Haas merch right here. Got Kevin Harvick on the side since this is his last season. But they got a lot of cool 29 merch that I'm seeing. Got all these Toyotas out here. We got good old Bubba Wallace just chilling out here. What's up, buddy? We got a Tyler Reddick car you can sit in and just take a picture with. That's kind of nice. Got a bunch of merch in this spot. Got a bunch of diecasts out here. It's pretty nice stuff. Bunch of Chase Elliott's.
I wish I had a dog named Smart.
Bunch of nice looking hats. Bunch of Jeff Gordon action figures. Got both of the Joe Gibbs guys, Tony Stewart and Bobby. A bunch of other action figures. Got a lot of tents out here. Bunch of it. So that's Chase Elliott's Atlanta win right there, and that's his Nashville win. A couple other 164s. Got a bunch of autographs right here. It's pretty nice. Mark Sherry's junior sign. Got a bunch of autographs here. Including Larry McReynolds and Jeffrey Earnhardt. Got all this cool merch, Junior Motorsports stuff. Pretty nice stuff up there. We got the RCR merch right there. Some pretty nice stuff. Oh, they do. Oh, they're
we got some of the best drivers. Did you mean on dirt, road courses? What do you mean? Because when AJ decided to go back cup racing, he says, I'm sick. I said, what do you mean? He says, I'm sick on East. I'm definitely not going to run a dirt race. So we had to come out and get some gain on him so he could clean himself up when he got done. And he just won at COTA, an Xfinity car. So that was exciting. Yeah, that's right.
And look at Everton Petty. You see all the dip stuck in between his fucking teeth.
You really can't. Look. That's dip.
That's dip right there. Wow. Yeah. right, so I got one of these gator masks because it's so cold, but very comfortable. He ended up getting one.
It's cold as shit.
Yeah, it's really cold. But now it's glasses are fogging up, but we got some cut racing to do. We got the cup heat right now. It's about to start any minute now.
Thank you. time for the truck race. I think my choice to win this, definitely going to keep out Ben Rhodes. Like, keep a watch on him. Tommy Carpenter, Jonathan Davenport, maybe Haley Deegan. It's possible. Zane Smith got the pole for this race. So maybe he can get it done. We'll see.
to meet you, man.
How's it going?
All right.
Just cold. After a year.
I'm just cold. So cold.
What's going on?
Doing all right, man. Doing all right. Nice camera.
Sweet, sweet. Let's start. Oh, it's super dark. Hold on one second. There we go.
What's up?
What's carbon 13?
Yeah, man. How long have you been here?
Huh?
How long have you been here?
I got here like as early as the base laps.
Oh, okay.
So, I've seen it somewhere over there.
Yeah.
Not sure where. But
okay.
I just sacrificed this.
finally in the hotel room. We're just getting our stuff situated. He's got his Xbox ready to go, and
I keep that thing on.
He's got a bottle of Jim Beam Black Extra Age Bourbon.
Don't sell at your local ABC store from now to May 1st.
Yeah. Thomas actually bought this Denny Hamlin Coke 600 win. Since I was able to get mine signed, which thanks Denny Hamlin for doing that for me. Actually, hold up. Yeah, could be, but hold up. So, I can see the DIN number on it. 576. Wait, what? No way. That says 576.
What's the box say?
576.
No.
Yo, that is a 576.
Want to trade?
Nah, I'm good. I'm good. I'm good. But that's pretty dope. But hey, you got something that's 576, and this hat right here is 245 out of 250, so that's pretty nice.
Look at us having all the luck today.
Yeah, I actually bought this. I mean, this thing's metal. I thought this thing was plastic, but no, it's metal. I mean, you can tell on the back. And got delicious Coca-Cola. Bought some die-cast as well. Got this race pin right here. Got a die-cast program car. Even bought this Alex Bowman glow-in-the-dark hoodie. Looks pretty good.
Let's see if it does glow-in-the-dark. Turn our lights off.
Oh, yeah. Let me see if it worked. So, my camera was messing up. It shut off, and then it cut back on, then it shut off, and I wasn't able to get the finish of the truck race, but luckily I was able to get the burnout. And, I mean, it kind of sucks because that's the first time it has done that, especially at that moment. And I wasn't able to get the Logano finish, but regardless, truck race was okay. And Logano pretty much led every single lap in the race. So, the heat races were okay. A couple people spun and stuff. There were some wrecks in the truck race. It was some pretty big ones for sure. But tomorrow is the big day. Get ready for the big day. And hopefully things will go our way tomorrow for Bowman. Hopefully, and Blaney. Either them two could win it or...
Watch them both wreck each other out the first lap.
That would suck. But anyway, I'm excited. This dude right there is excited for the race.
Really excited. Go Blaney. Realistic prediction. Who do you have winning?
Hmm.
I'm going to say Larson back to back.
I keep an eye on Larson for sure, but if there's going to be a sleeper in this race, I would keep an eye out for Derek Cope. He's not racing.
JJ Yaley, though.
JJ Yaley. Third. JJ Yaley was ripping it. He was fast.
And Denny, but watch out.
Denny! Okay, so if I'm actually going to pick a real, like, somebody who I think is going to win it, I would keep an eye out for Larson, Bell. I'm just going to throw this one out here. Yeah, Logano's a good one for sure. I would probably go with Bell. I think Bell could get it done, too. But we'll see. Now, it's about time to go to sleep. I'm tired. He's just getting the Xbox hooked up, everything. He's going to play some F1. So, good night. All right, good morning. We are about to head out to O'Charlie's, and we're going to stop at the Walmart real quick, get a couple things, and go to the racetrack. Looks like we got everything ready to go. It's pretty nice outside. Slept really good last night. Really sunny out today. All right, let's head on out to get something to eat, and we'll head to the racetrack. All right, we are walking towards the racetrack. We're going to go to the haulers again because there's a Bowman hat I do want to pick up. We're actually going to go to the souvenir tents because we didn't look at all of them. We only went like halfway on the other side. But the good thing is you can actually go across at the other end of the tents and go to the other side of the track. And it's windy out here, but it's not too bad. It's kind of warm out here, but it's the wind that's cold. But everything's all good, actually. I don't know how cold it's going to be tonight, but I'm all prepared for the cold air. I'm looking for a couple die casts that I'm going to pick up. And hey, there might be some die casts that are like a buck a piece. Probably going to buy a bunch of those. So we'll see what we can find. Bought the brand new LA hat. Looks pretty good. It's got the strip on it. Like it. It's pretty nice. It's got the 48 on the side and it's got Hendrick on the back. Pretty nice. That's nice. I like that. Got a bunch of Dale Jr. stuff.
That's back when I liked him.
Front clips. It's like a Josh Williams. Number 92. They got a couple Harvick stuff over here. Yeah. I do like that scheme. A couple of stuff right here. That's the Phoenix one. Got all the championships. That's a nice display case.
Yeah. Christ's name. Amen.
Amen.
Yeah. tonight, but I didn't do a really good job on the restart. Made mistakes where he got behind Austin and Kyle and some of those guys, and I think it was the difference in getting Christopher with enough time.
25 was probably my best car. He was just fast enough that you were around the top and weren't going to pass him unless you just made an incredible slider. So overall, you know, wish me obviously the picture lane, but.
Well, that was it for the race. Christopher Bell ends up winning. Insane race. I think this one was more better than the last two cup races. Truck race was okay, but the cup race was where it's at. And I'm just going to be honest, there was no respect on the track for that. Everybody was racing hard, beating and banging, which it's racing, but the moves they were doing is just mind-blowing, especially with the Ryan Preece and Kyle Larson issue. But either way, next week's Warrensville. That's definitely going to ramp up all the drivers for sure for those, since going to a short track now. But thank you all for watching the vlog. Thomas, you got anything to say?
See you next week at Warrensville, Chase Briscoe.
If you enjoyed this vlog, hit that like button, subscribe for more. If you want more NASCAR vlogs, I love every single one of y'all. I'll see y'all at Martinsville next week. And just remember, stay gold. It's Bristol, baby.